Good day. Live from across Northern California, happy holidays from Good Day.
All right, what if we told you that there is a light at the end of the tunnel when it comes to chronic pain? That's right, well, Tina's standing by with a doctor whose goal is to teach patients to live better and to manage their pain a lot better as well.
Yeah, this is Dr. Sheetal Dikaria from Chicago, and you got a new book coming out tomorrow, right? Is that it
right
behind you? Is that the one behind you? Or is that the first
book? Yeah, it is.
Break the chronic pain cycle. So you're talking about how sometimes people that are on daily medication, they're experiencing more pain, right? And your goal is to help people with integrative ways to do that, right?
Exactly, yeah. So my goal is to try to find out the root cause of pain. And what people don't realize is sometimes we're searching for all these reasons for pain, and it's actually maybe their everyday medication that's causing it.
And what you have some listed of certain medications that can cause pain. What are your suggestions? Which ones are they?
So the first, there's actually five medications that could be causing their pain that are very common. The first one is a statin drug, which is a cholesterol medication.
Okay.
And it actually can cause muscle pain in about 20% of people that take it, and nerve pain in another 10%.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah. What I usually tell my patients is that if you're going to have these symptoms and it's related to the medication, it's usually something that presents within days or weeks after you actually started it, not something that starts years later. So if you think you may have side effects from the medication, just start a conversation with your doctor about it.
Okay, and so that way that doctor and that patient can either change medications or figure out a dosage, right?
Yep, exactly.
Okay, what are the other ones?
So the second most common one are actually beta blockers. That's a blood pressure medication. And one of them is called carvedilol or Coreg. This one actually causes joint aches and back aches in 5 to 10% of people that take it. And it also reduces your level of melatonin, which is a hormone that regulates your sleep. And I have a lot of patients that are taking this and actually suffer from disturbed sleep that respond very well to some supplementation. The other very common one is called nifedipine or Procardia. That one can actually cause headaches in about 16% of people that take it. Now, for blood pressure medications, it's very important you don't suddenly stop them, but you have a conversation with your doctor about whether another blood pressure medication may be a safer one for you.
Okay, now, the third one.
The third one is diabetes medication. So metformin is used to treat type 2 diabetes, and this one can actually lead to 15% of people having significant vitamin B12 deficiencies. Now, the issue with this vitamin is that if you're deficient in it, you can actually either trigger or worsen neuropathy, which is a fancy term for nerve pain. Now, in diabetics, they have neuropathy anyway, but this can actually make it worse. So that presents like numbness, burning, tingling in your hands and feet. If you're having these, have your doctor actually take your vitamin B12 levels and supplement you if needed.
Okay, I got 30 seconds for number four and number five.
Okay, so the other common one are acid reflux medications like Nexium, Prevacid, Prilosec, super common over-the-counter drugs that can actually cause deficiencies in vitamin B12 and magnesium and cause nerve and muscle pain. I tell people just try to take less of the acid-causing foods and get off of this one or check your levels. The fifth being antibiotics. Everyday antibiotics such as ciprofloxacin or Levaquin can actually cause a severe nerve muscle joint pain syndrome. The FDA says these should only be used for severe infection. So if you do get prescribed this one, have a conversation about another antibiotic choice that may be safer for you.
Okay, tell everybody your website.
Sure, it's www.drdikaria.com.
Okay, very good. And look for her book too. It's coming on Amazon, right?
Yes, it'll be available tomorrow.
Break the Chronic Pain Cycle, Dr. Sheetal Dikaria. Thank you so much. All right.
Thank you.
Stay warm. She's saying it's 30 degrees in Chicago right now. A little bit cooler. A tiny bit cooler.
That's warm for us.
All right. Oh, okay. Take care. Talk to you later. All right. Back over to you, Jordan.
All right. Thank you, Tina.